One of the main incidents involving a person of color being unjustly killed by the police that was being protested against back in 2020, next to George Floyd, of course, was the death of Breonna Taylor. In March of that year, while in plain clothing, police carried out a no-knock warrant and raided her boyfriend's apartment that she was also living in at the time. She was in a previous relationship with a man named Jamarcus Glover, a drug dealer who has stated several times to police that Breonna had nothing to do with his operations, but regardless, she was a person of interest. Her current boyfriend at the time, Kenneth Walker, who had nothing to do with her previous boyfriend's criminal activities, opened fire at police, mistaking them for intruders. He was unharmed, but Breonna was killed in the crossfire. And now there is a pretty infuriating update to this story. From CBS News, judge rules Breonna Taylor's boyfriend caused her death, throws out major charges against ex-Louisville officers. A federal judge has thrown out major felony charges against two former Louisville officers accused of falsifying a warrant that led police to Breonna Taylor's door before they fatally shot her. U.S. District Judge Charles Simpson's ruling declared that the actions of Taylor's boyfriend, who fired a shot at police the night of the raid, were the legal cause of her death, not a bad warrant. Federal charges against former Louisville Police Detective Joshua James and former Sergeant Kelly Meany were announced by the U.S. Attorney General Merrick Garland in 2022 during a high-profile visit to Louisville. Garland accused James and Meany, who were not present at the raid, of knowing they had falsified part of the warrant and put Taylor in a dangerous situation by sending armed officers to her apartment. But Simpson wrote in the Tuesday ruling, there is no direct link between the warrantless entry and Taylor's death. Simpson's ruling effectively reduced the civil rights violation charges against James and Meany, which had carried to a maximum sentence of life in prison, to misdemeanors. This is so needlessly pedantic. Well, technically, the bad warrant itself didn't kill her, but rather her boyfriend firing at police. Yeah, and she'd still be fucking alive had police not shown up to her door at all that night. Or, at the very least, I don't know, identifying themselves as law enforcement before breaking into the apartment. This was a raid that occurred dead at night. Any person just chilling in their home at this time, and then all of a sudden they hear their door being fucking caved in, is going to immediately assume that it is an intruder breaking into their home with the intention of robbing it, or they have some other kind of ill intent, not police executing a warrant. The notion that someone is supposed to just comply with someone busting their door down in the middle of the night without them properly identifying themselves as law enforcement is absurd. Anyone with half a brain in this scenario would grab a weapon to defend themselves, and in this instance, he had access to a gun. This is self-defense 101, one of the tippy-top arguments I commonly hear from gun nuts, who think everyone in this country should have unrestricted access to guns. Next to, of course, delusional fantasies of rallying up a militia powerful enough to overthrow our government. Is this specific scenario defending your home from intruders attempting to break into it? Hell, I don't even like guns that much, but even I still think this is a perfectly valid reason to own a gun, so long as you are fit to own a gun. This was not an instance of someone knowingly shooting at police. This was an instance of someone thinking home invaders were breaking into their home. All of you conservatives siding with the police would 1000% do the same thing had this happened to you instead. Even the neighbors corroborated that the police did not properly identify themselves as they were breaking into the apartment. So was he, someone who had no involvement with the actions of her previous boyfriend, supposed to just magically fucking know that one night police will cave his door in? What else can you really call this besides racism? You have a dude who was well within his right to defend his home. But since this involves black people getting shot at by white cops, and many conservatives associate black people with thugs, you're going to side with the white cops who shot at black people who had no clue they were shooting at cops. I have a suspicion that if Breonna Taylor and her boyfriend were white, these people would be singing a very different tune. And then we have the fuckheads who have been saying, well, she dated a drug dealer, a criminal, so she got what was coming to her. First off, there is no sufficient evidence that I have heard of that conclusively links her to any of her previous boyfriend's crimes. Second, I don't fucking care. Why does her simply dating someone who engages in illegal activity warrant a death sentence? I don't think you need to die based on the company you keep, and the company she kept says nothing about the moments that led up to her death. She committed the egregious sin of just chilling at her home past midnight, something that most people are fucking doing at that time, until the police showed up. This is nothing more than the right scrambling to defend a clear-cut, unjust murder at the hands of the police. And they will keep doing this so long as police continue to unjustly murder murder people of color and not get properly reprimanded for it. To be clear, the case against the cops who actually shot her is still pending. This is merely for those who issued out the bogus warrant in the first place. But even still, in this specific instance, Breonna Taylor does not get any justice because without that bullshit warrant in the first place, she would still be alive. And her death should absolutely not be at the fault of her boyfriend, who was merely protecting his home. Plain and simple. I don't talk about it that much on my channel these days because I feel like I've mostly gotten it out of my system, but I still fucking hate cops. That hasn't changed at all. Stories like this are a glaring example as to why I have such a distaste for cops, and frankly, why you should also have a distaste for cops as well. I don't care how nice an individual officer may be, they still serve the same corrupt piece of shit racially biased system at the end of the day. That's all I have to say. Bye-bye.